How very thankful and grateful I feel, not having that rotting carcass, Jermaine Greer, domiciled and living in this great country of ours. What a dirty, low dog that thing is.
Oh, good.
Who's that from?
Who wrote that?
Me. Now, Gary. Oh, Gary.
Yeah.
Grumps.
Last week, we got a lot of flack. People are really getting the bracing bits about they don't find the stretcher stuff funny because, and I've actually been thinking about this, and we've had a meeting about this, and you know that because you're part of it. We're making light of people's injuries.
That's right.
So we have had a consensus. We're not doing it.
Good.
I'll just read out why people love it. And don't worry, it's not coming at the end, so don't think it is. But good. Dear Sam, this is from Margaret Landis of Ohio in the US of A. Dear Sam, I've been living in America now for 8 years, but I'm back in town visiting a sick friend. I've always been a huge fan of your show, and my uncle tells me you have some fantastic footage of Gary lying on a stretcher. My uncle says you always show it, and I'm dying to see it, because her friend's sick and she wants to actually just perk her up a bit. I'm only in town for 1 week. Could you please, please show Gary on the stretcher? It would make me ear. Now, see, that's what you've brought a little joy to people. We're not showing it, don't worry. That's from Margaret Landis of Ohio, Brendan. From very Jenny good, of Tacoma, we're moving on. What has happened to Gary's hair of late? Now, this is another thing. I'm sure.
Yes, Gary.
Did I say Jenny of Tacoma? I did.
Yes.
I'm sure he has done something to it. Can you please quiz him?
What have you done, Gary?
He's got a little grey spot.
This is getting a little tedious. I have not done anything to me.
Could we do a comparison? Now, we couldn't find. We couldn't find any footage of you as a sort of a child, but we've gone to the next best thing, and this is it here. Now, look. That's it there. Don't worry, we're not going to show the stuff. Don't worry. We did have some on your playing days, but that was on the stretcher, but we're not showing it.
Well, get on with it, will you?
Well, we're just saying we're not going to show it.
Right.
That's the only other footage we could bring up of current times.
Yep.
And but we have got some of the recent best and fairest, and we can make it there. Now, we think that it's just jet black all over, Gary. It's something going on there.
What have you done, Gary? You put a rinse or something in it.
What is it?
This is silly. I've done not one thing to my hair, and it's of no interest to anyone, so move on, you tool.
All right. I can't find the mouth.
This is from Cindy of Doncaster.
No, I won't do it. The next time you bump into Paula is ask him what Adam Goods gets up to in his spare time. This is a look-alike. Do you think that looks like Adam Goods? It does a bit, doesn't it?
Yep.
I've enclosed, this is from Shane of Lilydale, I've enclosed a picture of the minister, Kerry Hickey, from the New South Wales Parliament. My question is he a love child of your current CEO, Ed, and the man behind the bar, Trevor Marmalade? Oh! From Derek of Airport West, Sam, I was watching the Clive Barker film Nightbreed, and I think I found a lookalike of Carlton forward Brenda Favola. What do you reckon?
Yeah, it looks like me. Heaps.
That's a good one.
I'm sensing, exactly right, I'm sensing, Gary, that the only thing that's going to save this is the... But we're not showing it because people have got very annoyed about it.
They just
think we're laughing at you just in ill health. And finally, David of Beacon Hill in New South Wales. I still see players slipping on the Telstra Dome surface. Do you think this has anything to do with the stud design on current footy boots? Can you show us the sole of a current footy boot and compare it with one of yesteryear? Well, now, this will be riveting stuff. We're actually comparing football boots. Well, this is a current boot.
A screw-in
boot. That's it there. That's what they use on the Telstra Dome and any other service. Brendan, you'd know that.
Oh, we're mould, mate.
We couldn't find any footage of a yesteryear boot. The only thing we could come up with, and we'll highlight it here, we'll circle it so you can see it, is this footage of... There they are there. See them there?
sit there.
I specifically asked you just to highlight a freeze frame. Now do it again. Freeze frame of the boot, not the vision, because now we're getting more letters. Okay? So, Gary, sorry about that. I don't know why they rolled the vision. And I've been married a good half dozen times, and this has happened to me on every occasion, this Gary.
There is and never has been any other man for me, Robert, and I promise to love you and go on loving you until the day I die.
Claire, I can't tell you how happy you've made me.
I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride.
So this is it, we're really married now, yeah?
In the eyes of the Lord, yes.
Brilliant. I'll be holding that in for 4 years.
Right, if you want to send Mailbag, P.O. Box 800, Richmond, Victoria 31211, you can, or sams.mailbag@9.com.au. Bit flat to finish there, Samuel. It was quite a segment. Just trying to offer touch at the end. Now look,
why did she fail?
I'm not sure. I didn't get it either.
What sort of boots are those, Sam?
Hey?
What the guns Gary's wearing?
No.
As you work out what sort of boots they are, we are going to go to a break because...